So I want to talk to you about the Empal Muse. So this is my review of these headphones. Now these are the Muse Touch. And first up, let's have a look at the sort of design. Now the design of it is actually very nice. It's reminiscent of a few other designs that are out there at the moment. You've got like a slightly sort of ovaloid, sort of egg-shaped cup rather than anything else, which is, seems to be getting a little more the norm these days on some of them, and others are still sticking with the round, of course. Now, what you've got here is you've got your power button here. These are your touch controls. Now, if I press and hold that, now you may or may not have heard that, but there is like a little audible sound that tells you that it's turned on. Now that will possibly, or should have, now connected to my iPhone. Let me just bring that into view. And you can see there, it says Empal Muse Touch. Now what I've found is your volume on here and your volume on here stay sort of like separate. So if you're going to use them, the best way is that you would leave that on full volume and then just use this part for your volume, because obviously this would be still in your pocket. Now I've never had connectability problems between iOS and Empal products, because I've done a few of them before. So you can see that you just get the little blue flash like that. So that tells you that it's connected. It goes red when you're charging it, and of course you charge through the micro USB there on the bottom. This power button also doubles as your Siri. Now, it's not quite the same as on the phone, because obviously on the phone itself you would double tap or double press for Siri. This one is more of a 1 second press, because when you double press on Empal products, what it actually does is it calls the last number that you called. So that it's sort of a hands-free way of sort of dialing your last number out. These controls, they're a little hard to get used to start with. Once you're used to them, they're a little better. I find that the increments aren't brilliant on the up and down, but basically what you do is you start in the middle and you push up, and that's a volume plus and down, of course, and then you've got track forward, track back. And it is as simple as that. Once you've got used to them, it's very good, it's pretty intuitive, and I actually really sort of, you know, once I'd gotten used to them, I really liked it. You've got nothing on the other side apart from the company branding. It's got a sort of a non-gloss finish, so it's not going to be like a fingerprint magnet, which is nice. You've got some rotation in the ear cups there. These pads are beautifully soft, extremely comfortable, and you've got plenty of padding in there so that it's not pressing too hard against your head. Now, size wise, I have to have them on full extension, and I've got a relatively large head, so size wise, you know, if you're large headed, then you know you're going to need them at full extension. They're more of an on-ear design than an over-ear, but they would fit obviously over a child's ear or something like that. I find that they just leave the earlobe just sort of like sticking out a little bit at the bottom, but the fit is very comfortable indeed. I've not had any problems there whatsoever. Now they are Bluetooth 4, which obviously older Macs aren't going to work with, which is why obviously you left with your 3.5 jack here. The supplied flat cable is very nice, anti-tangle. Now volume and sound quality. Now on iOS, Bluetooth connected, I've really struggled to get the sound to distort, really struggled with that one. You've got to find something really bass heavy to get any distortion. What you do tend to get more than anything else is you get a bit of reverb on full volume, and it does sort of feel like you're sort of next to some much bigger speakers. I'm not sure what size the drivers are in these. I'm guessing around about 40mm, which is pretty much the norm these days. Now obviously once you start plugging in to something like your MacBook or a laptop, then you can turn the volume up much louder, and then you can obviously start to get some distortion as you get higher. Great. I've tried a variety of music tracks, from bass heavy rap right up to sort of orchestra music and what have you, and they just sound fantastic. And for the money, you can't go wrong. I mean, at the moment, they are a little under £60 on Amazon in the UK. And I believe they sell from the website as well. So I will leave all links to Empow underneath. A big thank you and shout out to them for sending me these out for review. I will put a full written review on my website, which should be up within a couple of days. Do make sure that you give Empow fans a follow on Twitter. I'll leave the link for that as well. And they also have a Facebook page. So I will leave all that underneath for you guys. So do check them out, and they are definitely worth the money. So there you go, guys. That's my review of the Empow Muse Touch Bluetooth 4 speakers. Cheers, guys. See you.